Hi everybody, Joey here again and welcome back. So in the past, I've shown how to build a large variety of aquariums. However, in today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to take one apart. There are three main reasons you might want to take an aquarium apart. You might want to salvage the glass from it for a new tank build like I did on my 540 gallon. You might also want to replace a broken panel, or you might even have a leak that a simple reseal won't fix. So in this video, I'm going to go over the tools you will need, how to take the aquarium apart using my method, and then we'll discuss what types of tanks you can and can't take apart. We'll start off with the tools. I use taping knives, commonly used in drywall applications. I like them because they're very thin, yet rigid and strong. I also use a razor blade and a handheld scraper to hold the blade. That's pretty much all I use. Now I take the tank apart in four steps. The first step is removing the top trim. Now to remove the trim, we use the taping knife. By sliding the knife all the way into the trim, we will release most of the silicone, keeping in mind that this is on the inside and out, paying special attention to the corners as these can cause the most problems. Now given the fact that a taping knife is so thin, it slides in easily. Also, due to it being rigid, it cuts through the silicone with ease. There will still be some silicone on top of the glass panel that holds the trim down, but we can't get to that without cutting the trim, which is a problem if you want to save the trim. So usually by lifting up on the trim a bit at each time on each side, we'll release that last bit of silicone. Now it's extremely important not to pull too hard or apply too much force, or you'll snap the trim or even break the glass. With the trim now off, we can move to the second step. We'll want to remove all exposed silicone on the inside of the tank. Now we'll do this with a razor blade. We don't need to worry about the silicone in between the panels because that will come later. With the exposed silicone removed, we move on to the third step, which is removing the bottom trim and the bottom panel. Now the bottom trim is removed just like the top trim. We remove the bottom glass first as it's actually the easiest pane to remove than the rest. We also remove it first due to the fact that it'll make taking the rest of the tank apart much easier. Now generally speaking, the bottom pane will have a large enough gap along the edge that you can easily slide in your razor blade. In fact, I've never taken a tank apart that didn't have a gap around the bottom pane, which is just filled with silicone. With the bottom pane out, we could take the rest of the tank apart. By slightly pressing the opposite corners together, we create small gaps on each seam. Not enough to cut right through, but enough to get a good start. As you rotate between each seam several times, the gap becomes larger and larger each time until the panels come loose. Now when doing so, it's important to take your time and not apply too much pressure or you'll snap the glass. Now that your tank's in pieces, we can remove all the excess silicone by scraping away all of the silicone that's still exposed with a razor blade and then wiping any residue down with a bit of acetone or something like nail polish remover on a rag. The tank is now ready to be put back together or a panel replaced or even simply salvaging the glass to build something else. The only type of tank that you can't take apart is an acrylic tank, and this is due to the seams actually being fused together on a molecular level, so there's technically no real seam to take apart, not without cutting it with a blade. Also, if your tank is 20 gallons or less, I wouldn't even bother attempting taking it apart. The value of your time and effort required to do so simply outweigh just buying a new one. Personally, I'll only take tanks apart that are 30 gallons or bigger. Anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I also wanted to thank you for watching, and we'll see you guys next week for a new project.